I got these two brothers, and they're about as close in age as two brothers can be, but they're about as different in temperament. As you can imagine, you see, Doug's a very pessimistic fella, and Johnny's awfully optimistic. And I never realized how much this difference was until one Christmas I come downstairs, and there Doug and John were sitting under the Christmas tree. Now, Doug, as usual, cleaned up. He got a bicycle, you see, and he got a pair of skis, and he got a new electric train. Johnny, on the other hand, his luck was holding pretty good. He had this big plastic bag of horse manure. So I says, "Douglas," I says, "what did Sandy bring you?" "Well," Doug says, "he brought me these skis. I can't keep them on my feet. And that bicycle has a wobbly front wheel, and I can't keep a train on the tracks." Well, I got sick of listening to that, so I turned over to Johnny, and I says, "What did Sandy bring you, Johnny?" Johnny, of course, had his hand in that big plastic bag, kind of reaching around in there, and he says, "I don't know, Joe. I think he brought me a pony, but I ain't been able to find it." My little granddaughter, she come home from school the other day. They were having show and tell. And she'd taken a little pet mouse to school that morning. Well, she had it out playing with it while the teacher was up the board writing down some stuff. "And," my granddaughter says, "the mouse got away. Run across the room, down the aisle, and right up the inside the teacher's leg." "Well," I says, "I bet that made you nervous, your mouse getting away like that." "Well," she said, "it didn't make me half as nervous as teacher. You can't believe the amount of water she squeezed out of that mouse."